Okay, we are speccing a game. We got Jay Tedder and Weekend on the other team, and Exultants on the other team here. Looks like we are Chaos and they are Order. What are we picking? Terracer Cat Hercules. Okay. Why Cat when you have Terra and Herc, right? Longer the team fight, the better. Longer the team fight, the better. Shorter the team fight, the better. Rom can kind of do whatever he wants, but I mean, in general, all hunters are pretty long fighters. Poseidon, burst, 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 length, length. Somewhere in the middle. Let's look at their side. Burst, 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 setup. They have three burst carries. You have not so bursty carry, very bursty carry, very bursty carry. Set up with heal. Set up with heal. So the front line is going to have to be much more bursty than they want to be, I think. We'll see what happens. When you guys get in the game, Kabrakan, Poseidon, Cat. Poseidon has better, well, not really better clear, safer clear. Cat has very unsafe clear compared to Kabrakan. So Poseidon should be helping Kabrakan. Dual lane, you guys aren't welcome to the tower. That's where you're going to be sitting. Solo, I mean, Herc has a decent matchup against Bellona, so that's okay. We'll see what happens. Let's go to match, please. Okay. End of match here. See what happens. I'm gonna be speccing Rom. My second role is ADC, so I selfishly believe I somewhat know how to play it. We'll see how this goes. Okay, right off the bat, there's two Hogs on the enemy team. You guys should notice that once you get in the lane. You're not going to be taking any objectives. Cat's going to hug too, that's okay. Makes sense at this point. But what does that mean? They've got Beads, Hog, Tully, Hog, Blink. You have a med. Use the med. Sustain the fights. But you don't really have sustained damage, so, I mean. I would almost like to see Poseidon build a lot of cooldown because of that. Just to get more damage off rather than one big burst. Because if the fights are going to be lasting a while, then you want a lot of little spells rather than one big one. But they only have one pair of beads. Or they have one thing of beads. That Anubis should be dead like 50 zillion times, dude. Right, you're wasting a lot of time with that. Okay. It's a few seconds. I don't hate that because you're gonna have no push pressure. They might actually. No, you need to pull that. That is bad. You lost a lot of time. They're probably gonna beat you to lane now. You have to pull that immediately. You don't have to tank it, but you do have to pull it immediately. Are we checking our phone? Yeah, Stu took a lot of poke because you missed a few autos. So you're obviously doing something else. Yeah, they beat you to lane. They should never have beat you to lane there. So duo pressure's gone. I mean, you're looking at the wall. Why are you looking at the wall? The minions aren't at the wall. There you go. You stood in the wave. Never stand in the wave. You cannot stand in the wave. You stand in the wave, you're just going to get poked for free. Thankfully, you've got a terror to help sustain you, and you have death tolls, but there's no reason to take that impale. You should have, 100 more health than you do right now. Okay, Stu, that second dash should have been right out. If that on her still was impale, he would have just popped you right into that wall. Check out the mid. You guys are losing really hard. So what's happening? I didn't see how... What was the taunt? Keep your bracken off your tower? He's not going to dive you. He's level 3. You're sustaining pretty well. They're getting free meds. You should be able to call that. So when are those meds up? You saw him go there. Meds are up at 4 minutes. 5 minutes, rather. I can do math. They're invading? It's actually a bad invade, but then they didn't actually watch where you went. So... Okay. Sirkat is really easy to get caught out. You're actually kind of lucky that Anubis just completely whiffed that. Poseidon's dead. Anubis has 5. Run away. Check out Solo. Hey! Good job, Rick. Rick's winning the potion battle as well. That's a dead Bologna. Wow. That was really dumb of that Bologna. He just stood still for the Herc Boulder. That was beautiful. Okay, let's check out left lane. Okay. Pause for a second. You beat that stun, right? It was the wall stun from Terra. Why did you beat that stun? Okay, Honor's pillar is already up. His impale's already down. He's already used those spells. You know that. You were the target of them. Why did you beat the Terra stun that's way far away when Honor doesn't have any spells and Kabrakan isn't close to you? It's just something to think about, right? Because you have to think about constantly what abilities are up. They have Disperse, Kabrakan 1, and Terra 3. Right? Did I get that right? Oh, Terra used her 3 already. Okay, that was before I got there in my own defense. Disperse. Kabrakan 1, which you just procced. Kabrakan ult, and Kabrakan 3. So I missed a couple of abilities. So right now, Kabrakan's ult's up. You know that. You should know that. Terra's already dead. So, watch your pathing. Why are you here? Kabrakan's going after Terra to ult her. So there's going to be a wall here. There's a wall here already. Terra just used her wall. So, you have this path to get out. That's your only path to get out when Kabrakan's going there. Right? So why did you run here after Beatsing? So, in this situation, Terra needs to run here. You need to run there. Because you're at full health still. So you are the peel. This is the direction the peel should be going because the ult's going to be here and block them in. The peel needs to survive more damage. Terra needs to run here and try to bait herself out so Rom can get out. There's the ult. Got him. Now, imagine if that was Terra there. Look at how much health Kabrakan has. If he ults here, he probably doesn't get a kill. Or if he does, he probably dies because you're putting autos into him freely from this way because Honor's impale's not up. Just little things to think about. You always have to keep track of. So Kabrakan's backing. Okay, you knew those were down. You watched them go and do them. Let's check out Solo again. It's done. She's obviously already used her bludgeon. That's her dash. Fire elementals are up. Nice stun. Oh, you didn't use a stun there. That was actually really smart. This is why I'm not in solo line. Oh, we're fighting? Where are we fighting? We're not. That was really fucking weird. Terra ult. Okay, cool. Grabbing mid. Casey, what are you doing, buddy? Invading 2v3. Come on, boys. Your Sirkat's level 4. In no world do you win that. Okay, you didn't know where Kabrakan was because he'd just backed. So why did you invade their speed, which is the first place Kabrakan's gonna go? And for God's sakes, it's weakened. Like, the man never loses speed. So you just hogged your speed. That means they get a free Gold Fury. And they just killed your Poseidon, so that's a really free Gold Fury. Let's check out this side. What are you doing right now? You're not doing anything. Honor's getting free autos into your support. You need to be putting some autos back into him. Even if it's just, 55 damage per auto, that's a lot of damage. It stacks up. You got yourself impaled? Wouldn't those beads be nice right now? Or you could have ulted on reaction to the stun. Really good jump from Honor. Oh, that was hot. It's a hot jump. That was interesting. Okay. They shouldn't have traded that. And careful how hard you're chasing you. Let's check out mid. So, your jungle's still level 4. So, honestly, everybody just stay up here and let him just get all this. Because he can't fight anything. Kabrakan's gonna dodge your abilities and not care. Because his Anubis ult isn't up yet. Let's cool down on that. 27 seconds. I bet around 5:30 we're gonna see some aggression from that Anubis. Excuse me. Gooby just got the red. Hey! What do you know? It's like I know the cooldowns or something. Honestly, you were gonna die anyway. You knew that, or I knew that. You didn't necessarily. I'm not sure what information you had at the moment. Ult him. He's dead. Rom snipes. Nice. Just go. You're low. He's your peel. He's keeping them off you. You just need to run. I know you want to come back in. You're tanking archers, though. What's your build? You have boots. You don't have Devos for sustain. They can clean that up. Trust your team. It's a carry and a support against a low health carry. They should always win that. Trust your team. I think you should have just backed right away. But you did get another wave, so that's good. Maybe I'm wrong. I don't think you needed to chase for the kill. Going for the wave was fine, but I don't think the kill is necessary. Inspect Casey and see what he's doing. Jumped in. He got your speed. That's fine. Okay, you missed your taunt. Yeah, just run. You missed your taunt, and your jump's down. All your abilities are down. You do not need to run into where he should be going. I was wrong. You had a rotation coming in from your team. That was an interesting deathbane. Why'd you jump back in? You're not going to kill the Anubis. You just use your ult. Just never mind, the Anubis is an idiot. Right, the Anubis doesn't have beads. Good pluck from Brick. We lost the hunter for that. What are we getting? So Rom versus Honor, don't try to take that boxing match. You have to play safe. What are you building into, by the way? I'm just curious what your thought process is, right? Because are you going... That was awkward. Are you going into Aussie? Let's think for a second. What does Aussie give you? Aussie gives you physical pin, attack speed, lifesteal. So what do you need the pin for? Not Anubis. You do for Kabrakan, but he's got flat reductions anyway. So you're going to pretty much negate the Dynasty Plate Helm with that. I hope you're not trying to kill Bellona. Terra doesn't have any protections anyway. And Honor's going Yggdrasil. So you obviously tried to box him. I would consider going Yggdrasil just to survive a little longer in the boxing matches. I know that seems weird not going Lifesteal, but if you're not going Devos, and I think Devos is the right choice, by the way, I think you need to go the Yggdrasil in order to have a chance at somewhat trading evenly. You're not going to, but at the very least, you could poke him out a little more. And I don't mind taking 1v1s as a hunter, but taking 1v1s while your team's ganking the other side of the map is a dumb idea when you're not supposed to win that matchup. What did they use? They used Kabrakan ult. That's dumb. So why are you doing boars instead of positioning for a wave? Because you can get there in time. Good choice. Well, that Anubis is fed. Really fed. That's awkward and unfortunate. Oh well. I think 1 into 2, maybe? Rather than 2 into 1? I'm not sure. There's not much you can do here except survive. Oh, really good body block. Nice try. I thought you had her. Rotations in mid. You've got 3 in mid against Anubis. That is a fat ass Anubis. Okay, where are you looking, Casey? What do you know? Kabrakan's ult up, now I know. You jumped in. Good deathbane. Good setup from Stu. Priorities. Rom's alone in mid. Rom is alone in mid, and you know that Kabrakan ult's up. Okay, so Rom was here. Well, these two are just staring at him. Okay, you can't be there. You can't be there alone. And you can't leave him there alone. But this one's your fault, buddy. Let's see what happens. I actually like that ult choice. Oh my gosh, we can miss his stun. Oh, that was a hot cripple. I like the fighting back. I think that was all you could have done. Ult onto Honor when it jumps up. It's a little tricky. You got him, though. Really good ult from Brick. Can't really count on that, though. He should have been able to dodge that. Keep track of cooldowns, guys. It's a stun. Oops. That was the wrong person. Who did I want? I wanted Mike. I'm gonna lose tier 1. They should get tier 1. Nice dodge. Read like a book. Anubis just tanked a lot of tower. They can't get tier 1 now. Greedy play by Anubis. Nobody's touched gold yet. Which is good for us, because they have more secure than we do. If he just stole this, it was sick. I don't think he did. Why is there Bellona in my mid lane? Weird as shit. Why is she here? Casey, what you doing? Casey, what are you doing? That's a Bellona. That's a Bellona, Casey. That's a Bellona. That's a Bologna. I'm sad. It does 342 damage, Casey. Bologna has 1600 health. And 5% Cabrakan mitigation. Kraken does 220 plus 60%, 280 damage. That's not even half her health bar. Careful, man. I know you really want to kill that J-Tetter. But you're just not going to like that. So honestly, the Hercules ult just saved the tower. It's not going to accomplish anything else, because it can't. Good taunt. Really good taunt. Don't jump in. I know you want to jump in. Jump away. Jump away. On her beats. You still have more... Good body blocks. Nice cripple. He's out trading you. Why is he out trading you? He has Ickeville. He also has two levels on you and Ossie as well. But the Ickeville's not helping. Okay. We're losing really badly. What do you do? Stem the flow. What do you do? And they also just got a free Gold Fury. But you should know that. You should also know it'll be up at 19 minutes. So what do we do? Pause the game. Right here. What do we do? How do we come back? Can we come back? Is it even possible? Let's look at what we have. You got a Fed Anubis with no Aegis. So, Sirkat's best friend. But Sirkat's underleveled and doesn't have any magical protections, so she can't jump on Anubis. In fact, she has no protections. Can't kill the Onher. Can't kill a Bologna, we discussed that, I hope, enough. You could probably kill Cabrakan, but he does mitigate most of that. Or some of that, so it's kind of tricky. Mostly Anubis. Just kill Anubis. So what do you need to do to kill Anubis? You need to survive Anubis burst. So after that crit, honestly before that crit, I would have liked to have seen like a Bulwark or Pestilence even, because Anubis lifesteal. Just so you could get your ult off on cooldown, you know? Ult Anubis, ult Anubis. Bulwark is really nice because it has CCR, so maybe you can get out of that wrap. What else do we have? Stu has Med, Brick has Med. They got a curse. There should be another curse from them, probably, because we don't have a sprint yet. Stu's building. I don't really, really, really don't like Ben Boots. Cooldown. You want more ults. More walls, more stuns, more heals. Not slightly, vaguely more powerful heals. I want to look at the ability. Heal. 5% of your magic power per tick. And 0.5 seconds for 10 seconds. So 20 times, so it's 100% of your magical power. Which is a lot. But you got 45 magical power. It's not a lot. Unless you're building like Rod of Asclepius, which is late game, right? This is way early game. Rod of Asclepius is like 6 item. I want cooldown, and you can sell it for pin later if you really need the extra power. Or you could even go reinforce Grease and get E-Staff later to give you bonus power for health. Going into Urchin Cloak, okay, there's lots of fighting. I'm down. It's probably the best thing you could have done. Auras aren't going to help against that. Dave's trying to live more. Okay. No Dynasty Relay. No, it's not a physical jungler. I'm an idiot. That's right. You're right. Brick's building into units. I mean, hey, the carry's there, right? He's the only one that can take any damage. I'm okay with that. I want more boulders, more plucks, more stuns. I still don't like this build. I think you need to go Devos or Ikaval. And if you go Ikaval, then you can go Ahzee into Xe or Chins. If you go Devos, then you can go into Xe and Crit. But I don't like this build in the slightest. You don't have enough pen, or you don't have enough attack speed for Chins to really be worth it. You don't really have enough pen to be a tower killer. And if you build Executioner next, then you don't really have enough power to be a people killer. So you're missing. First thing you need is power. Second thing you need is pen. Third thing you need, attack speed. Fourth thing you need, Chins or Crit. Right? Depending on the ratio of power to attack speed. If you got mostly power, go Crit. If you got mostly attack speed, go Chins. He's going the Chins build. I guarantee you that'll be in a Chins. He might get a Crit on him just because he's so far ahead. What in the world, J-Tetter? What are you doing? It's free. Nice pull. Nothing you can do, though. You really do need magical protection, I think, over Jotuns. I think the Jotuns is probably a bad decision. Okay, pause again. Where are you running? Running to this tower here? Could you have run with Poseidon? I'm not sure. I think you should have tried to if you could have. Why'd you roll then? Suppose it doesn't matter. They want a Dave anyway. Why are you going back in? You literally have zero chance of doing anything there. Right? You still have zero chance of doing anything. You have no penetration. You have no power. You have no attack speed. You cannot kill either of them. You have to run. The best thing for you to do now is honestly sit on Phoenix. And wait for Mike and the Kraken to respawn. The Kraken's down. Wait for Last Breath to respawn. Okay. I'm okay with that roll. Good cripple. Really good cripple. He was probably going to jump in on you there. I like the fact you held beads. Where's Kraken? What's he doing? He's gonna walk under a tower and kill you. Okay, so we need like 5 zillion magical defense on this team right now. Not even joking. Like, all of you have to build Bulwark, or Pestilence, or Heartword, or Genji Garb, or whatever that other one is. You guys can't win this. Anubis is getting away with living with one defensive relic. One defensive relic. Why? You know? Mean, this one isn't even about shot calling. You lost all your lanes. Every single lane lost. And you guys aren't thinking. You don't walk into that. Don't walk into that. Don't walk into that. You're dead. You're dead. Like, you guys cannot fight the Anubis without CC into burst. Her beads are down. CC into burst. The only thing that's doing damage right now on your team is Kaycee's ult, because it's true damage. Kaycee's ult and Brick's doing a little bit of damage. Okay, your ROM isn't doing any damage. Terra never does damage. Never does damage. Kaycee at least has Deathbringer and an ult with true damage. Poseidon's going to Gem of Isolation, not doing very much damage, right? We're lacking in pen. Goddess here going into that. Brick, I know I love Jotuns as much as you do, but I would switch those, really. Because you have to survive the Anubis. Why'd you roll in there? Because there's no damage there. That was a good roll. Don't take it, Kaycee. You can't do anything more. Huh? You can't do anything more. I mean, you guys aren't gonna win this. I don't think there's anything more I can offer to this game, so I'm just gonna.